فعاش القلب إخلاصا، وصرت تحوم كالطير تحلق في ثقافات وتنهل من ربى الخير.
Today is something very, very important. A lot of us feel bad when we are reminded. If someone tells you, Taqillah, what does that mean? Fear Allah. My sister, fear Allah. What? You fear Allah, okay? Yes, that's the response you get sometimes. You say, Taqillah, Taqillah anta. Come on, we're just saying, fear Allah. The hypocrites, what's the sign of a hypocrite? وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُ اتَّقِ اللَّهَ أَخَذَتْهُ الْعِزَّةُ بِالْإِثْمِ فَحَسْبُهُ جَهَنَّمُ. When he is told, fear Allah, he becomes even more hardened in his sin. Allah says, such a person, Jahannam is sufficient for him. Don't do that. When you are reminded about something, thank the person reminding you. Allah sent them and Allah will ask you, didn't we send you a reminder? And if you say who, he will remind you and how you responded to them. So one of the ways of achieving righteousness, and it's in the verse of the Quran, is to be able to take admonition in your stride correctly. To be able to take reprimanding the way it should be taken. To be able to take correction and thank the person correcting you, and thank Allah that someone has come to correct you. I recall when I was a student, I had a friend. And sometimes he used to be very offended when he was corrected. So one day he had got up from his sleep and he had some of the fluff of the blanket on his hair. And he had this habit of pouncing on anyone who corrected him. So I told him, you know what, you just need to take off. What? I was shocked. I said, no, there's a bit of fluff on your head. Look at your own head first, okay? Huh? Okay. So now he walked around with fluff and everyone's looking at him and giggling, giggling. You know how it is. But yeah, that's the giggle that happens to us. When someone tells us, read salah, dress appropriately, turn to Allah, quit your sin, make tawbah, repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what happens to us? We couldn't be bothered. Sometimes we say, ah, leave these guys. Don't let that be the case. You're a true believer, change your life. And don't say, inshallah, I'll change. Now, here, today, now, promise Allah, Allah, my life is changed. I just want to lead a good, clean, pure, decent life in a way that I go to Jannah. And I know I will struggle. My brothers and sisters, the struggles of this dunya are created in order to test you. Without those struggles, there is no test. What was the point of having a world without difficulty? And what was the point of creating paradise if this world were to have no difficulty? So this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks of a certain group of people. Do you know what is Amr bil Ma'ruf and Nahi anil Munkar? It means to encourage people to do good, to encourage others to do good, and to discourage them from bad. That's what it means. So if you were discouraged from bad, how would you react? That's a good question. So Allah instructs us to encourage one another to do good and discourage bad. And on top of that, this verse that I'm about to recite from Surah Al-A'raf, verse number 164, reminds us that when you and I are reminded about what is right and wrong, don't become upset. Listen to the verse. وَإِذْ قَالَتْ أُمَّةٌ مِّنْهُمْ لِمَ تَعِظُونَ قَوْمًا اللَّهُ مُهْلِكُهُمْ أَوْ مُعَذِّبُهُمْ عَذَابًا شَدِيدًا قَالُوا مَعْذِرَةً إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَلَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَّقُونَ. There was a group of people who used to constantly remind others about what was right and wrong. So one group tells that group, why are you wasting your time reminding these people and warning them when Allah is going to punish them and destroy them anyway? If Allah has written punishment, that's what will happen. If Allah has written destruction, that's what will happen. So some people, they say, well, if Allah has already written what is going to happen, why waste your time reminding people? I'm sure you've heard that statement before. That if Allah has already written who's going to heaven, who's going to hell, why waste your time reminding them? Leave them. Whatever's going to happen will happen. The truth is, you and I don't know where we are heading or anyone else is heading, so we need to continue trying. Perhaps that's what was written by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't know. He knows. But He didn't tell us. That's all part of this game or part of this life. Subhanallah. So do you know what was the response of those who had knowledge and those who knew that this reminder will definitely benefit? No matter what Allah has written, you need to continue to remind. They said, ma'dhiratan ila rabbikum. We are continuing to warn these people in order for us to have an excuse with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have fulfilled our duty when Allah asks us. We will be able to say, yes, we did do this. Allah asked us, did you remind them? And we will say, yes, we did. That's why we are reminding them. So that we can have a good response with Allah. So continue to remind and to warn and to give people hope and so on. Why? مَعْذِرَةً إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ. To be able to have that excuse when you meet with Allah to say, no, we did remind. Because it's your duty to remind. وَلَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَّقُونَ. And who knows? Perhaps they may achieve righteousness through these reminders. Do you know whom Allah has written righteousness for? No. Do you know whom Allah has written misguidance for? No. So what if you reminded people and as a result of your reminder, Allah guided them? Don't you achieve? So continue doing that. This is why this verse has in it two or more lessons. In fact, many lessons, but two of them. One is, continue to remind people. And two is, when people remind you, now you're on the other side of the boat, the other side of the coin. Take it correctly. When people warn you, thank them. Don't become arrogant and haughty, because in that way, you won't be able to turn to Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us piety. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us goodness. May Allah forgive our sins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us success in this world and the next. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.